40 Filipino evacuees from Gaza are set to arrive in Manila Friday. The full story from our Middle East correspondent, Maxi Santiago.
The 40 Filipinos who arrived in Cairo have mixed emotions. They are finally safe, though they worry for all their loved ones who are still in Gaza. One of them is Lucina Sera Jose Al-Kadiri, whose son was left in Gaza.
My son, who's an eldest, having a newborn, who's not well. So naiwan sila kahapon. Kami lang apat na anak ko, saka yung isa kong apo ang nakatawid sa border. So naiwan yung mag-aama ko. My son, the newborn, and my daughter-in-law.
She remains hopeful that her son will cross into Cairo safely.
We are praying to God na sana matapos na itong gera na to, kasi lahat apektado na lahat. Mentally, emotionally, psychologically, everything, all the aspects of our life affected talaga. Hindi lang kami, pati lahat ng natagagasa.
OFW Isabelita Bautista Vallejos, who worked as a household service worker in Gaza for 23 years, is going home for the first time. She is apprehensive of what lies ahead.
Nag-aalala po ako sa situation ko. Hindi ko po alam kung saan ako magsisimula ulit. Sana ko kukuha. Sana matulungan niyo po ako kung ano ang maibigay na pagkakakitaon ulit para meron akong magamit sa kabuhayan, dahil talagang walang-wala po ako talagang.
They were lucky they were able to leave the besieged enclave, since the Rafah crossing at the Gaza side has remained closed since Wednesday.
But the good news is all the remaining Filipinos have been approved. And they have approved 16 of the Palestinian spouses. Not all. There were some who were not allowed because they did not pass the security checks.
It really depends on their ability to reach those who are on the list and those who are able to reach the border and be processed in time. Then I believe the next list is already out.
According to the DFA, 22 Palestinian spouses who are married to Filipinos are given clearance to cross Rafah. According to the Philippine Embassy in Jordan, 48 Filipinos are waiting to cross the Rafah crossing, including a household service worker from Kuwait who was taken by her Palestinian employer to Gaza. Maxi Santiago, ABS-CBN News, Cairo, Egypt.
Possible relief for civilians caught in the crossfire in Gaza. The U.S. says Israel has agreed to daily four-hour pauses in its relentless assault against Hamas. The White House says the move will allow civilians to flee. A second humanitarian corridor along a coastal road also set to open.
We believe that this is an important step in the right direction. We believe that it is a byproduct of the U.S. government and this administration's efforts in the region. Diplomatically, what the President, Secretary Blinken, and others have been doing around the clock. Of course, we are going to continue to want to see more. We have not parsed our words about the dire humanitarian circumstances in Gaza, and it's something that we're going to continue to engage on with the Israelis on what other avenues are available for ensuring access to humanitarian aid and humanitarian pauses that will allow for the safe movement of civilians.
There was no immediate lull, though, as the bombings continued through the night. U.S. President Joe Biden now says a longer pause is needed to get hostages out.
Why is the delay in getting hostages out?
We're hopeful. Things are moving along.
Did you ask for a three-day pause to Netanyahu?
You know, I've been asking for a pause for a lot more than 3 days. Yes.
Did you ask him to pause for 3 days to get the hostages out?
Yes. I've asked for even a longer pause for some of them.
The United Nations calling for coordination with all parties concerned amid the reported pauses in Gaza. The UN says right now they are seeking out more information about the daily halt in Israel's offensive in order to take advantage of the situation.
How any such halt in the fighting and how it would work for humanitarian purposes would need to be coordinated with the United Nations, especially on the issue of timings and location. And obviously, in order for this to be done safely for humanitarian purposes, It would have to be agreed with all parties to the conflict to be truly effective.
The International Committee of the Red Cross resumes escorting patients to the Gaza border after a convoy shooting earlier this week. The group says that incident was deeply alarming as it calls for safety guarantees for volunteers.
For those who have been displaced to the south of the Gaza Strip, they are having to live in extremely difficult and cramped conditions in overflowing shelters. That do not have proper access to water and to sanitation. And the situation is frankly alarming. Unless there is a reduction in the hostilities and if humanitarian aid is able to enter at a greater rate than it currently is, then the lives of those civilians will become increasingly pressurized as resources become ever more scarce.
The organization also says Palestinians displaced to southern Gaza are still facing dire conditions after fleeing the violence in the north.
Of course, the severity of the incident we take very seriously. The ICRC was targeted the day before yesterday, and that is unacceptable. However, to the extent possible and where the conditions allow, we will continue our humanitarian activities to meet the urgent and escalating needs of the civilian population in Gaza, despite the toughest of circumstances.
Thousands of Palestinians have fled northern Gaza in recent days, traveling miles on foot as Israel intensifies its ground and air operations. Over the West Bank, 14 Palestinians were killed as Israeli forces raided the city of Jenin. The hours-long battle between Israeli troops and militants was one of the heaviest clashes in the West Bank in months. Rubble and debris were strewn across the streets and bloodstains could be seen on the ground. Four more Palestinians were killed by Israeli soldiers in separate incidents across the occupied territory. At least 178 Palestinians have been killed in the West Bank since October 7. In Gaza, the death toll now stands at over 10,800. Now, four Filipino crew members are injured by a Russian missile's attack on their Liberian flagged ship. One other person was killed in the attack that happened at a Black Sea port. The Philippine Migrant Workers Department says the four injured Filipinos are out of danger. It has instructed the ship owner and the crewman's manning agency to provide them with the necessary assistance. The incident comes months after Russia withdrew from a deal which allowed the safe exports of Ukrainian grain from the Black Sea.